was Jafar was Imam Ali's brother. So she married a cousin basically. So when Abdullah was being married to Lady Zainab, she had put a clause in her marriage to say that whenever Imam Hussein was going out somewhere else and she wanted to go, he would allow her. And Jafar accepted this condition of marriage. And then the marriage was done. Now, Zainab was a big support from Imam Hussein in Karbala, and after all of them had died, she was a source of strength for Imam Sajjad and all the ladies. Now, we spoke yesterday about how she was scared sometimes when the armies were gathering in Karbala and the drums were beating. And once Imam Hussein had held her and comforted her and said a dua to her, and after that she never felt scared. She felt a lot of strength after that. She was known to be very strong throughout the episode of Karbala and through Sham. Our salam goes to Lady Zainab. When she sees the despicable man shimmer on the chest of her brother, yet she's brave enough and she shouts to Umar ibn Sa'd and says, "O son of Sa'd, the son of Fatima is being slaughtered by Shimmer and you're sitting there doing nothing?" That was a bravery. She was seeing her brother being slaughtered and she wasn't getting affected, but she was steadfast in that calamity. In the evening, she was seen pulling the children away from the tents after the tents had been plundered. She was like a guard, protecting and reassuring the ladies and the children. She had the misfortune of seeing her loved ones killed, beheaded, the heads being put on swords and spears, and the bodies being trampled by horses. And they were tied in chains and taken to Kufa and Sham. Yet her spirit was unbroken. She was steadfast. Imam Sajjad called her Alima Ghair Muallima, which means the knowledgeable one who had no teacher. She had divine teachings in her. When they were being taken to Kufa, they were taken around the bodies which were unclothed and mutilated. And Imam Sajjad was so upset, as if grief along with illness would overpower him and a death will come to him. And Lady Zainab came to him and said, "Oh, my dear beloved nephew, take control of your emotions. Otherwise, if you will die, then Islam is going to perish. Do not worry about your father's burial. Allah will take care of that. Allah will ensure that in Karbala there will be a shrine for your father where millions in droves will come to pay their respects to your father in love. Lady Zainab took care throughout the tribulations to make sure that she spoke the truth every time she got an opportunity. She was taken to Kufa in chains. This was the city of her father. This is where she taught the Quran to people, to the ladies over there. And Ibn Ziyad ordered for Imam Sajjad to be killed. And Lady Zainab threw herself on Imam Sajjad and said to Ibn Ziyad, "You'll have to kill me first before you can touch my nephew." This was how brave she was. Ibn Ziyad taunted her and he said, "How did you find the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Karbala?" The reply was amazing. She said, "I saw nothing but beauty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Who says that? Can you imagine the reality of truth that she was seeing there? She indicated that there was nothing but beauty from Allah, but the tyranny was all from the people of Ibn Ziyad and Yazid. Allah was always good, and the torture was inflicted by these people who were wretched. The most painful for her was when she was paraded in Damascus. And they were paraded in Damascus and presented in the court of Yazid as captives. The Ahlul Bayt were captive in front of more than 100 courtiers, some of whom were ambassadors from different countries. Yazid sat there drinking wine and disrespecting the face of Abu Abdullah Imam Hussein alayhi salam with his stick. Lady Fatima salamu alayhi had stood in the Masjid al-Nabi. She was fully clothed with her sheets and her hijab, and yet she could not tolerate the calamities, and she turned her hair turned grey, and she passed away soon. Can we imagine the situation of her daughter Zainab? how she must have felt in that situation. I mean, the character that she showed there was amazing. When she was leaving from Medina with Imam Hussein, her husband Abdullah could not go. Yet he brought two of his sons, Aun and Muhammad, to Imam Hussein and said, take these as my offerings. I can't go because I'm sick, but take these as my offerings, take them with you. They will support you in your mission. On the eve of Ashura, Lady Zainab is seen encouraging and inspiring her sons Aun and Muhammad to sacrifice themselves for the truth, which is with their uncle Imam Hussein alayhi salam. On the day of Ashura, when everyone was starting to die in the battle, the companions had perished, and one by one, the Bani Hashim were dying. Lady Zainab said to her sons, go into the battle and sacrifice your life for your uncle. They tried to get permission, but Imam Hussein would not give permission. And they came to their mother and saying, uncle is not giving permission. And Lady Zainab got upset and said, I'm not going to talk to you till you go and give your life for your uncle. Ultimately, Imam Hussein gave them permission in his grief. And they came to their mother and said, oh mother, are you happy with us now? And she said, no, I'm not happy till you give your life for your uncle. They went away. Their uncle Abbas prepared them and sent them out to the battle. They fought bravely. Those two boys fought bravely. They were the sons or grandsons of Ali and Jafar, who were famous soldiers. Umar ibn Sa'd saw that they were dispersing the army, just two boys. And he said to his soldiers, do not take them on one-on-one combat. These are the grandsons of Ali and Jafar. Ambush them in a group. And that's what happened. And they became martyrs in Karbala. Imam Hussein and Abbas went out and got their bodies to the tent. But Zainab didn't mourn for them. She said that it's not the time for mourning now. And when they were captives in Damascus, she had not mourned for her children. And Yazid, after watching the trouble that was happening in Damascus of what he had done, wants to release these captives and send them back to Medina. Lady Zainab laid down three conditions. She said, first of all the possessions that have been plundered from the tents of the Ahlul Bayt should be returned. Secondly, they should be provided a place where they can mourn for the martyrs of Karbala. They had been stopped for even crying for their martyrs. And thirdly, they said that the caravan which goes back to Medina should be sent via Kufa, or via Karbala rather, so that they can visit the graves of the martyrs and their close relatives. Yazid agreed. In the heart of his capital, the first majalis of the mourning of Imam Hussein was held by Lady Zainab Salamullah Alayha. We owe these gatherings to her. My dear brothers and sisters, this is a gift from her that we have this tawfiq to sit here and remember them. And one by one, the heads of the martyrs were brought. Umm Layla saw Ali Akbar and she grabbed hold of her son's head and she cried. Qasim and Abdullah's mother cried. Rabab cried for a six-month-old baby son with her head. And Lady Zainab held Imam Hussein's son and cried. They all moaned and the ladies of Damascus saw and heard the stories from them. But there were two heads that were unattended and there were whispers going around that these must be orphans, and Lady Zainab was hurt beyond words. She said, don't say that. They're not orphans. I am their mother, but now I will grieve for my brother first. When the grievance had finished and the majalis had finished and they all moved on and gone to Medina, Lady Zainab could not bring herself to go inside the house. She was remembering her children then. She sat on her doorstep crying. The journey had changed her so much. This tragic journey had changed her so much that even her husband Abdullah could not recognize her. Abdullah thought that somebody was begging at their door. And he told his other daughter, Do not keep these people waiting. Give them something so that they can go away. And Zainab cried aloud, "Oh, Abdullah, you do not even recognize your beloved wife now? I have changed so much that you do not recognize me now? I've lost my brothers in Karbala, and I've lost your sons in Karbala as well. Allah, 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 Qawmi Zalameen. Sayyalam al-lazeen ayyahum khalibun mun khalibun. Inna lillahi wa inna alayhi rajiun." Oh Allah, we ask you to accept this offering that we have made this evening to you in remembrance of the martyrs of Karbala and the strong people who kept the message alive and brought it forward to us. Give them the highest levels of paradise and give us the tawfiq to be on the side of the truth. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ala al-tayyibin al-tahirin al-masumin. Allah sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ala Brothers, I've finished the majalis slightly earlier today. If you have any questions, please do ask. I was told yesterday to tell you this earlier. And also, when you go upstairs, let the ladies go first so that there's no traffic jam outside. And once the ladies have gone, then you can go upstairs.